Harvard National Model United Nations is one of the most coveted events, which brings about 3,000 delegates from more than 70 countries to discuss global challenges. As Team NSIT gets ready for yet another round of discussion and deliberation, we wish the delegates all the
best. Something which is a mixture of public speaking, a little bit of theatrics, different procedure per se, but in the end the matter, the content is very, very centric to international affairs. This is something that I tell my delegation as well. So we are Indians. Indians are supposed to be very, very smart. So even though we do not do a lot of GK, we can like get up to speed for international affairs within a month or so. So that is in fact a part of training. So even though you're not a part of MNN culture per se, if you really are a good public speaker, if you understand how the world functions,
we'll all be going to different committees and we have different agendas. And now that what that means that all of us are now specialized at one thing and we know this subject much better than most of the people on the planet right now.
Which is true.
So it gives us a much better perspective on the world.
Over 100 countries. That is what HNM1 is about, meeting so many people and interacting with them and actually participating in debate. MUN is a part of it, but then it's the wholesome experience.
Being a part of the selection panel itself, so there has been different criteria every year. This year, like last year, I remember we focused a lot on talent, only talent. Like if someone has the potential to be a very good public speaker per se, we focused a lot on that. This time we took a few other aspects into the criteria selection and everything. So talent was not the sole option. We also looked for people's understanding of world affairs because the timing was the duration of training was shorter this time. Then we saw how good could they research, how well would they gel in a team, are they a team player or not, whether they understand what are the basics of diplomacy, will they ever change the stand. And such soft skills are also necessary in becoming a very good delegate, especially in an international month such as the Harvard National Month.
That soft skills is very important. We can know our subject all that we want to, but at the end of the day we are interacting with other people. And we need to like really understand those people and we need to converse with them properly. And in that matter, we are different from what delegates for an Indian MUN should be. We are supposed to be more polite and we should be better understanding of those people. And hence lobbying is a very important facet of our
team. I think one of the most important things that is required in an MUN is to think on the feet. Because research is something that everyone does. But it is important to think logically, think analytically. Draw conclusions from situations and to think on the spot, to be able to react spontaneously to situations. That is what makes a good MUNer, according to me.
We have a Harvard Business School visit in which we are also going for the lunch, and
then we are also, after the conference, we are going to visit the UN headquarters. We are going to visit the Empire State Building and the World Trade Center. From Central Park to everything else.
Yeah so a very, very detailed itinerary at New York and
basically we have I have a whole itinerary ready for New York, day by day experience. And like New York in February during Valentine's, it's going to be a hell of an experience.